Now, I'm delighted to say we're in the company of Aidan Morgan here, AM Hurley's main sponsor for the Hurling Championship in Monaghan this year. Aidan, first things first, we have to commend you on the fantastic facilities and premises that you have here. We're actually standing in your shop here to deal with all your hurling wants. And I know out the back, we seen earlier on the workshop that you have there and that as well. It's testament to yourself and a lot of hard work over the lockdown. Obviously, we find ourselves here.
Yes, Sean, I suppose when I started out here at the Hurley's first, it was the small workshop across the way, and really Hurley's was the only thing I was at, and then it's kind of grew on to having the wee shop and office and stuff here, and more of a cleaner environment for people to come in and look at. We just expanded to a number of different, you have slitters and grips and footballs and basketballs or whatever else, just to give people an extra option when they come in too, and but a lot of hard work and long hours, but we're getting there slowly but surely.
What I love about it, this is development. A man making hurls. I know I spoke to you during the early part of lockdown. I couldn't believe there's a man in County Monaghan making hurls. Yeah. And it probably is a signal to that the hurling in the county is climbing as well. You've come in on the back of it. We've talked to the teams that are going to be involved in the championship finals, and they've all talked about how competitive it is.
I would find, like, from my time in Clahan as a full-time coach to my time as hurling officer and now in my own business, I find from this year, obviously, we didn't have sevens, nines and elevens, but the last couple of years, you're seeing a large number of players playing at that age. The under-13s this year, there was some cracking games. Ourselves and Carrick McCross had a great game. Ourselves and Castle Blaney had a great semi-final. I was up at the under 13 final on Sunday, Carrick McCross and Castle Blaney, and again the skill level I find at that age is flying. And I suppose with the restructuring this year, maybe of the junior and senior championship has given us the option of maybe more competitive games, that that we're not seeing more one-sided games. And that's the likes of the Monaghan Harps guys talking to them outside there. They're kind of saying this year's fantastic. Why? Because they're actually fit to compete rather than playing against maybe the Castle Blaney or Truth that has got a wee bit ahead of the other teams.
Yeah, and you talk about the underage teams there, and I know even from a football perspective, they get to a final. It's amazing. They never remember the cup or if they win or lose it. They always just remember being there on the day and being part of the occasion.
Absolutely, absolutely. Them, I know our young lads in Clontibret won the Shield 2 years, I think it was. They won it and they missed out the following year and they won it the year after that. But I think the cup final was actually going ahead in another pitch that night, maybe in Clahan. Them boys didn't care that that was a grade higher. They were so focused on their game. And regardless what it is, you know, and it's getting out and it's a final and the event and everything, and it's fantastic. You know, the more games we can create, the better.
Of course, and that means then it's the foundation for even looking ahead and years to come. And you noted it there. The junior championship, that slight change in structure this year added to the competitiveness. As I say, no team wants to be going out knowing that they're beat before they get to the field. The thought that you can go out and be even a little bit competitive is a big bonus.
Definitely. And that, I'm no longer the hurling officer due to work commitments and stuff here, but when I was there, I kind of looked at the bigger picture, and Castle Blaney have a massive pool of players. A lot of them really only getting Development League hurling, and you're kind of looking, these boys are training the same as everyone else, they're not getting the game time. And Latin's building the senior team at the minute, doing great work at underage level, and again, them boys aren't getting competitive games. They can't compete against the stronger clubs, and even the likes of ourselves in Clontibret, we're kind of keeping the thing going over there. We haven't a huge pick of players, but we're tipping away, and we kind of said, if we don't do something to accommodate these teams, we're going to lose teams very, very, very quickly. And it kind of means now that the likes of Clontibret and Latin and the Blaney B team, them guys are getting competitive hurling in a junior championship now. Then that's going to follow on this year into a development league. Will they get more competitive games? And look at even the likes of Castle Blaney, that's getting a bit more competitive hurling there too. It's fantastic. And we decided to have a two preliminary round games at the start of the championship to decide who went into senior and who went into junior. And there was even a wee bit of an edge there because some teams didn't want to go down to junior. Do you know, so them two games I found were fantastic. And even from that on, you know, when if you went into the senior championship and you lost your first game, the pressure was on, the same thing was in the junior championship. So it left, rather than us playing the round robin and you win one game, you're nearly into a final, it meant you were trying to push on every game to get the wins this year, which is great, you know.
Which is what you want. I think there's a lovely tie into the story as well. Your development, you're going forward, you're looking to the future, and it's great to see. No doubt you tied in with the hurling in the county here as well because of your background with it, but you also see that same path going the same way that you went.
Absolutely. Like, I would never have thought even getting to where I am today, and I find it's growing here. And look, at you have to be thankful to the people within the county too. Like, I've got great support from people within the county, at even at county board level, and the clubs and everything. And the relationship I built up, some good, some bad, but with the clubs in the county over the years, has been fantastic. And it's paying off in business now. But I like to be involved, and I would still be hurling officer within the county just for work commitments, you know. And I don't like saying no to too many things, but, you know, just the demand of meetings and one thing and another, and you just couldn't commit. And look, at one thing had to go, and that wasn't going to be my business. So unfortunately, it was the hurling officer, but I'm still involved. I'd be in contact with the PRO, the chairman, on a weekly basis, and we're still trying to improve things regardless. And look, I'm quite happy to assist in any way I can, you know.